Greetings in the name of Yahwah HaMashiach. At the end of today's broadcast, I'll have a mailing address, phone number, and website. Please stay tuned.
Greetings in the name of Yahwah, the only name given among men, whereby we must be saved. And we do appreciate each and every one of you who has taken your time to tune in this program. And it's very needful to know the truth. See, traditions and doctrines of men and men's words don't mean nothing. That's why we're where we're at today in churches, because of so much tradition, because men are trying to interpret the word of Yahwah. But it's of no private interpretation. That means I can't interpret it, and you can't interpret it. Usually most of your interpretation comes from these preachers. And there's a lot of honest and sincere preachers, but there's a lot of dishonest and not sincere preachers. And they have taken people and made gain of them in these denominations and organizations instead of letting the word of Yahwah help the people. They have brought people into bondage. You only know as much truth as what you're hearing. You need to study along with us, see whether we're telling the truth or not. We're going to be turning over to the book of Romans. Again, we're going to go back to the 10th chapter. I'm going to start in the 17th verse, and we're going to try to move on into the 11th chapter. But we've been taking the 10th chapter and trying to go take the 10th chapter of Romans, compare it with Old Testament Scripture. Now, I like to get into a lot of stuff, but we're in a time, a day and an hour, you're hearing all kind of stuff on the radio, but you're not hearing the truth on the name. You're not hearing the plan of salvation like it was taught by the early assembly. So in the book of Romans 10:17, matter of fact, right before we do, I want to go over and read a verse that we normally do in the book of Matthew, the 26th chapter, because of what the Mashiach said. It says, this is Matthew 26:12. It says, "For in that she have poured this ointment on my body, she did it for my burial." Talking about the Mashiach. "Verily I say unto you, wheresoever this gospel shall be preached in the whole world, there shall also this that this woman hath done be told of a memorial for her." We do this because to be obedient to what the Mashiach said is the only reason I do this. And matter of fact, I do it because the Messiah said it. But he said, when this gospel is preached, well, you're fixing to hear the gospel, the true gospel, maybe for the first time that you've ever heard if you just tuned in this program. We're reading from a red letter edition King James Bible. And usually as we say every week, the original 1611 King James Bible did not have the name of Jesus in it. It had I-E-S-U-S. Then it backtracks to I-E-S-O-U-S. But why? Before it's over with, by the time you get to your King James Bible that you have in the Greek, then into the King James Bible, the original 1611, then into 1769, known as the Red Letter Edition, what we're reading from, you've got three different names. But what? And none of these names were ever given by any prophets. No prophet ever gave witness to Jesus, Jesus, or Jesus. They didn't give no witness that the Mashiach would be called Yeshua, Yahushua, or Joshua. There's not but one name given for the plan of salvation. There's not but one name given for the plan of salvation. And we're fixing to dig this name out. We're going to dig it out. We're going to dig it out in Scripture. We're reading from Romans, the 10th chapter, the 17th verse. But Apostle Paul, in his time when he was writing this, he was writing this and digging in the Scripture for the foundation of what you would have known today as the book of Romans. The book of Romans was written, they say, between 57 and 60 A.D. So what we're doing, we're going to do just like Apostle Paul. We're going to go back to what Apostle Paul was talking about. We're going to go back that give witness that Apostle Paul used. So Romans 10:17 says, So then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Now I'm reading how the King James says. Now, if you do a search on this and check this out and think a little bit on what the prophets gave witness to first. I said what the prophets gave witness to first. If you was to read verse back up in verse 16 of Romans, 10:16 of Romans, where it says, but they have not all obeyed the gospel. For Elias, which is talking about Elijah, or which is talking about Isaiah, and it says, King James says, Elias, or talking about Isaiah, saith, Lord, who hath believed our report? Now, Apostle Paul's quoting from Isaiah 53:1, who have believed our report, and to whom is the arm of Yahwah revealed? This is how Isaiah 53:1 actually reads in your King James Bible, in Isaiah 53, using King James Bible now. But you see the word L-O-R-D, capital letters. It give witness to the name of Yahwah, is what it done. Why would Apostle Paul come against something that a report was given? Matter of fact, if you go to Isaiah and read Isaiah 53, you will find that Isaiah 53, and matter of fact, part of Isaiah, the latter part of Isaiah 52, in the 13th verse, and matter of fact, in Isaiah 52:13 down to the 15th verse, it's talking about the Messiah. And when you take Isaiah 53 you will find out who smitten the Messiah. It was Yahwah, is what it says. Study Isaiah 53. And it will explain to you by name from where the king... Now, King James is going to use the word L-O-R-D in capital letters. And a lot of translations today are going back to what the scripture would have given as a name. So when you understand this in Isaiah and you study this out, the one that had smitten the Messiah, it calls him by name as Yahwah, who had smitten the Mashiach. And that Mashiach, in other words, he was smitten by his own father. His own father had his own son crucified, according to Isaiah. Once you understand this, you have to understand who the Father is to understand who the Son is. Until you do, you will never understand it. Matter of fact, in the book of John, St. John, now I'm going to go back to Romans here, but since we're doing a little search, if you go to the book of St. John and you examine this in verse or in chapter 12, you go to the 38th verse in St. John 12:38. This is what it says. Now, there were some things that had to be fulfilled and to be done. And if you read up above, you will see what this was talking about. It was talking about the miracles that the Messiah done. But if you continue reading, it explains why these miracles were done. And this is the reason it says in St. John 12:38. That the saying of course, it's the word Elias, which is Isaiah, the prophet, might be fulfilled, which he spake, Lord, who hath believed our report? And to whom is, and to whom hath the arm of Yahweh been revealed? Now, this is the Messiah. This was talking about the Messiah to ever who wrote, which would have been Saint John, who wrote Saint John, 1 John, 2 John, 3 John, the book of Revelation. He's referring back to Scripture of what the Messiah fulfilled. I like to look at it this way. From Genesis to Malachi has all the history and the timing and the beginning and the ending of the world that we live in right now. Everything is done from Genesis to Malachi. What's going to take place tomorrow has already been recorded from Genesis to Malachi. Anytime you read of what the King James might say, the coming of the Lord, as the King James says, but it would really be using the name of Yahwah. It is the blueprint laid out for the whole world, the beginning and the ending of it is from Genesis to Malachi. Isaiah 800 years to 800 to 1,000 years before a Mashiach come on the scene had already prophesied of a suffering Mashiach. It's the same way with Jeremiah when it talks about the establishment of Israel, the coming of Yahwah. And Jeremiah also give witness of a Mashiach. Moses, same thing. Abraham, the same thing. From Genesis all the way to Malachi, the world is only in existence because of what has been spoken beforehand. There was a lamb that was slain from the foundation of the world. That means before the world was in existence, Yahwah had a plan. Yahwah had a plan laid out. He'd already seen a lamb slain from the foundation of the world, and that was the Mashiach. Every sacrifice that had anything to do with Israel for sin offerings, feast days, anything was all pointing to a Messiah. They were only the image, but the Mashiach, they were only the shadow of things, but the Mashiach was the very image of those things. Isaiah's only prophesying what was put in his spirit, what had already been laid out from the foundation of the world. The world is only in existence because of the mercy and grace of the Creator of heaven and earth, having a lamb slain from the foundation of the world, knowing that Adam would sin in his time. Adam was not created and made a sinner. He was in the image and likeness of his Creator. The image and likeness of the Creator was in the Mashiach. And the Bible even talks about this in the book of Romans. So when you see Genesis to Malachi, you're seeing a masterpiece that holds the whole future of the world in existence. So in St. John 12:38, that the saying of Isaiah the prophet might be fulfilled, which he spake. And the King James says, Lord, here, who have believed our report, and to whom hath the arm of Yahwah been, and to whom hath the arm of Yahwah been revealed. Now, I want to go back over to the 10th chapter of the book of Romans, the 16th verse, because of time. But there is so much to cover. The word for gospel that we was talking about a few minutes ago in Romans 10:16 is a Hebrew word called basura. And it actually comes from the word about glad tidings. And we've been through all this. So in the 17th verse, when he says, so then faith cometh by hearing, hearing by the word of God. You have to understand, he wasn't talking about the word of God being Romans. He's talking about the word of God from Genesis to Malachi, what Romans is established on. That's why Romans has an establishment, and it is the word of God, is because Romans is backed up by the word of God from Genesis to Malachi. Before the book of Romans was written, you had the word of God. Let's say it this way. You had the book of Romans from Genesis to Malachi before it was ever written as Romans, what you read today. Romans just didn't all of a sudden just come into existence. All of the epistles, all of what you would call the New Testament, was already from Genesis to Malachi. It was just a time for the picture to start developing. That's what you've got. So then, at a particular time, Yahweh had in his plan for the book of Romans start to develop. That was already concealed in Scripture, but was revealed under the blood of Mashiach. In the testament where the blood of Mashiach was shed. So then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. The same way with the book of Acts. The book of Acts was already from Genesis to Malachi. It was already prophesied in the book of Joel, what would be used for the book of Acts. It's not something that was just happened. They just didn't start writing the book of Acts. The book of Acts was an act of something. It was a developing of what was from Genesis to Malachi that was to happen. Things begin to fall in place, develop. It's a lot of time just rushing through and saying, you know, a lot of times people don't really realize about this stuff. Because people try to teach you a New Testament without understanding the Scripture. Trying to teach a New Testament without understanding what the Word of God is. The Word of God is from Genesis to Malachi. Every epistle was from Genesis to Malachi. It was just time for it to develop. But what they've done today, they've taken the very author out of his own book, is what they've done. So when you read Faith comes by hearing, hearing by the word of God. What you're really understanding is from Genesis to Malachi. Now watch verse 18. If we get to make it that far. Verse 18 says, 10:18 of Romans. But I say, have they not heard? Yes, their sound went out into all the earth, and their words unto the end of the world. Now, look at this, and again, here we find in the book of Psalms 19:4, this is quoted. Psalms 19:4 talks about, and their words to the end of the world. This book of Psalms that David wrote. 19:4 of Psalms is where Romans 10:18 was quoted from. That's Psalms 19:4. From Romans 10:18 quoted Psalms 19:4. Now we got to establish something with the word of Yahweh. Your faith is established by the Old Testament. In other words, the Old Testament was the New Testament concealed. The New Testament was the Old Testament revealed. So faith cometh by hearing. It's not just something they just popped up and started writing. It was already written. It was already written. Even when the Messiah was tempted, he would always go back to what was written. And even Satan knew what was written. That Messiah was the written word of Yahweh in a robe of flesh. The book of Romans 18:10, but it says, but I say, have they not heard? Yes, verily, their sound went into all the earth, and their words unto the ends of the world. Now this was quoted from the book of Psalms 19, book of Psalms 19:4. Now we need to search the scriptures here. And when I'm talking about scriptures, I'm talking about taking the New Testament, understanding the books in the New Testament, that they are based on Scripture. I said they're based on Scripture. All right, the book of Romans 10:19 says, but I say, did not all of Israel know? First Moses saith, I will provoke you to jealousy by them that are no people, and by a foolish nation will I anger you. Now, this here is actually quoted from the book of Deuteronomy 32:29. Remember, the book of Romans 10:19, Apostle Paul is referring back to the book of Deuteronomy 32:29. Now, if the Old Testament is done away with like people are teaching, and people are teaching this, they're actually teaching that the Old Testament has been done away with. Now, several months ago, it's probably been close to a year now, there is a particular apostolic oneness organization, one of the biggest there is. One of their main men wrote a book called In the Name of Jesus. And in the book, the man denies that the assembly was baptized in Yahweh's name. He quotes verses. And the verses he quotes, he needed to look at what he was quoting because they disagree with him. The Bible says that every knee shall bow. He says that they won't. The Bible says that every knee shall bow to Yahwah. He says that they don't. The early assembly on the day of Pentecost had no writing of no New Testament at all. I asked the same man that wrote the book. He acknowledged that it could not have been in the name of Jesus. But then in his own book that he wrote somewhere within that time after we got through talking. Now this book's been written several years ago, and I talked to him several years ago, right before this book was written. And see, this is the kind of stuff that's dangerous. Denominations and organizations have tried to make the word of Yahweh to none effect. They're traditions. I said, they're traditions. Right in the book of Deuteronomy 32:21, this is where Apostle Paul, when he wrote the book of Romans 10:19, it says, they have moved me to jealousy. Now, you need to go back and find out who the who me is here. Where it says, they have moved me to jealousy. You need to find out who the me is here. If you would back up a little bit and read these verses, you're going to find that this is talk. This me here was Yahwah, not Jesus, but Yahwah in the verse 21. Deuteronomy 32:21. It says, they have moved me, the me here is talking about Yahwah, to jealousy. The same one that brought them out of Egypt. No, Jesus brought them out of Egypt. No, Jesus was revealed to Moses. No, Jesus was revealed to Abraham. No, Jesus was revealed to Noah. You go and look who Noah built his altar, what's known in Hebrew as Mizbeach, his altar, to. Same way with Abraham, who was called Abram, then later on become Abraham. Go over there and check it out. They have moved me to jealousy with that which is not God. They have provoked me to anger with their vanities, and I will move them to jealousy with those which are not a people. I will provoke them to anger with a foolish nation. All you'd have to really do is continue reading this. Then you again are going to find out who the me is. Here in Deuteronomy. It's not hard to understand that. It's not hard to understand, but what they've done, they've come in and they have taught a tradition that the name of Yahwah, from where your King James Bible, from a translation that it was translated from, used the name of Yahwah. The original 1611 King James Bible was translated from a translation that used the name of Yahwah. Now, but you're being taught, and have lost the memory of who the God of Israel is. Let me say it this way. If you've never been taught it, then you didn't lose the memory of it. But somebody started tradition that knew who Yahwah was. It's sad, the day and hour that we're living in right now in 2017, that the church, even the apostolic, Pentecostal, Acts 2:38 believers, don't even know the name of their God because of tradition and doctrines of men. Once you hear the truth, once you hear the truth, I'm not talking to people that's dead. I'm talking about people that hears the truth and rejects this. There's going to be a lot of sad people on the day of judgment, because of what's being taught in these denominations and organizations. You got people claiming to be prophets, prophesying about the end time, and they prophesied over and over about the end time. And it hasn't happened yet, and it won't happen until a particular time. And they won't tell you the truth. I said they won't tell you the truth. There's going to be a lot of blood in this generation that we're living in now. I'm not talking about people back a long time ago. I'm not going to judge them. I'm talking about in the generation that this message is being taught. This generation is not going to get by this message. This generation will stand before a creator that tried to reveal his name to a generation. Right here in the book of Romans 10:19, from where it was quoted from Deuteronomy 32:21. I'm going to read it again. It says, but I say, and this is in Romans 10:19, it was quoted from Deuteronomy 32:21. But I say, did not Yisrael know first? Moses saith, I will provoke you to jealousy. by them that are no people, and by a foolish nation I will anger you. Now, here's Apostle Paul talking about Israel. Go to Deuteronomy and find this out. 32:21. A foolish nation, I will anger you. Now, in Romans 10:20, it says, but Isaiah, which is talking about Isaiah, is right here in Romans 10:20, is very bold and saith, I was not found of them that sought me. I was made manifested unto them that asked not after me. Now, here's Apostle Paul again, going back to Scripture. In Isaiah 65:1 is where this is quoted from. That's Isaiah 65:1. It says, I am salt of them that asked not for me. I am found of them that sought me not. I said, behold me. Behold me unto a nation that was not called by my name. Now, I encourage anyone that's listening to this broadcast, examine the name who's doing the talking here. The Creator of heaven and earth. Let me continue reading, and we'll back up on this a little bit here and read it. It says in verse 2, I have spread out my hands all the day long, or all the day, unto a rebellious people, which walked in a way that was not good, after their own thoughts. Now, I want to go back to the verse 65:1 of Isaiah, the first verse we just read. I encourage you to study this here. It says, I am salt. Now, who is the one that's being salt? Who is the one that's being salt? I am salt of them that ask not after me. Who's the me here? I am found. Find out who the I am is talking about here. Found of them that sought me not. Again, here's the me. I said, find out who the one that said, I said, behold me unto a nation that was not called by my name. Now, the Creator of heaven and earth, here in the book of Isaiah, if you go to Isaiah, you're going to find out who the Creator's name is. All you've got to do is read up above and below in these verses. If you would back up into chapter 64 of Isaiah and start reading, And you continue in 65, just keep reading. You're going to find that there's not but one name that was used. One true name. Because it's going to, the King James is going to show you the word Lord, L-O-R-D in capital letters, in these verses. You, in other words, where it says called by my name, the name, this is not talking about the name of Jesus. This is talking about the name of Yahwah. Now, remember, this was, remember Isaiah. Quoted or read from Apostle Paul in the book of Romans, quoted and read from Isaiah here. In verse 21 it says, but to Israel he saith, all the day long have I stretched forth my hands unto a disobedient and gainsaying people. Remember, all this is quoted in the book of Isaiah 65, verse 1 and 2. Just if you read, if you continue reading, you'd find out that the name of Yahwah is used here. Of course, it's covered up with the word L-O-R-D in capital letters. But what is so sad is this. Is that none of these verses that Paul is talking about is referring to the name of Jesus. Not one quotation. Not one quotation. Not one. You would have to literally break Scripture, destroy it, to come up with any other name other than the name of Yahwah. In other words, in verse 21 here in the book of Romans, but to Israel he saith, you go and you study out Israel, and I promise you, you're not going to find that Israel knew any other name other than the name of Yahwah for their God. Now you're taught, they start coming in with all these, what they want to say, names of Elohim, El Shaddai, El Gibor, and all this stuff. And these are Hebrew words. But they don't do away with the name of Yahwah. The reason why they use this stuff is they're trying to deceive you and tell you that God is many names, and all of a sudden they slip Jesus in on you. And that's exactly what's happened. And people have failed for this stuff without studying. Preachers have failed for this stuff without studying. They know what somebody told them, but they don't know for themselves by searching the Scriptures. And the Messiah told Israel when he walked on the face of this earth. He says, search the Scriptures, St. John 5:43. For in them you think you have eternal. That was 5:39 of St. John. 5:39, he says, search the Scriptures. For in them you think you have eternal life. And they are they that testify of me. Talking about the Mashiach. Now we're going to move on into Romans, the 11th chapter now. That's Romans, the 11th chapter we're going to. Remember, up to this point, we've been taking you from New Testament back to Scripture, showing how the Apostle Paul was using the books of the Old Testament, what people understand as the Old Testament, in his message that he was writing to the Romans. 11:1 says, remember one thing, when he said provoke you to jealousy, how is he going to provoke Israel to jealousy without identifying himself to somebody else? And that's exactly what he done. He didn't give Israel know the name of Yahweh, then all of a sudden the Gentiles gets another name of Jesus. The name of Jesus is less than 250 years old. Pushing it to be 250 years old. Romans 11:1. How can you? Now listen to this. How can you argue with verses in the New Testament going back to Scripture in the Old Testament giving witness to Yahwah and not knowing his name in the New? There's not but one true God. That's like the oneness apostolic people wants to quote Deuteronomy 6:4 to try to preach a oneness message. And when you go to Deuteronomy 6:4, it literally uses the name of Yahwah twice in it. It's Deuteronomy 6:4 is not giving witness to the name of Jesus. And that's it. It's not doing it. People will come up with some of the foolish stuff, but people hear this from others, from foolishness. We've all been guilty of this. I've been guilty of it. Because people say, well, we're Gentiles, we speak Jesus. Listen, you wouldn't have a chance if you really believe that. You couldn't back up what you believe. I said, you cannot back up what you believe. If you can, please call me. Please call me, and you'll get a telephone number here in just a little bit. I want you to call me. We will be willing to come to anywhere anybody's at to teach this message and back it up from Genesis to Malachi using a King James Bible and into the New Testament, the whole writing of the New Testament, to back it up using a King James Bible. It will work perfect. You just have to know how to study with it. Several weeks ago, we were reading in the book of Hebrews in the 9th chapter about the tabernacle. Ever who the writer was in the book of Hebrews, they had knowledge of the tabernacle. I encourage you to go over to the book of Hebrews. the 9th chapter, study on the tabernacle. Study on the layout, the order of the tabernacle, the sacrifices of the tabernacle, the priesthood, every sin offering. Every bit of it can be proven from Genesis to Malachi. That all of it, the tabernacle, the priesthood, the altars, are basically it's the same creator. We're just living under a different priesthood through Mashiach. The priesthood, the order of the tabernacle, the sacrifices, every feast day they had, was done only in one name, and that was the name of Yahwah. That's the end of it. What is amazing is people will teach the Old Testament. Never one time questioned the word L-O-R-D, capital letters, G-O-D, capital letters. When from Genesis to Malachi is given witness to only one true God, if you want to say it that way, as King James says, with one true name, and that's the name the Mashiach said that he come in St. John 5:43. Examine this. Check this out. That even in the book of Joel, Apostle Peter, who had the keys to the kingdom, used Joel's prophecy that used the name of Yahwah for the plan of salvation for the early assembly. And you're being taught that we're Gentiles. That is so foolish. That is foolish, is what that is. There's no scripture on this, but people fail for it. But Yahweh's going to wake his people up. He's going to wake his elect up. You can mark that down. In the book of Romans, the 11th chapter of the book of Romans, we're going to start in verse 1, but right before we do, we're going to pray. Father, through your grace and mercy, from Genesis to Malachi, that it already had laid out the future for a New Testament, through the blood of your Mashiach. And we ask you to help us in this broadcast, help everyone that listens to this broadcast, somehow in their spirit, you will quicken them somehow in their spirit to know the truth on this. And take all of that deceiving spirits and doctrines of devils that's being taught in this end time. All this false teaching that's being taught. Yahweh, through the Holy Spirit of the Creator of heaven and earth, that everything's going to line right back up to exactly how you witnessed it to your prophets in the scripture from Genesis to Malachi. In Yahweh's name, amen. Let it be so. All right, book of Romans, the 11th chapter, verse 1. Paul says here, he says, I say then, hath God cast away his people? God forbid. For I also am an Israelite, I'm reading out of the King James. James says, of course, it says Israelite here. Of the seed of Abraham, of the tribe of Benjamin, or what is known in Hebrew as Ben Yamin. You know, the word, what you call Benjamin, is really a transliteration using really the same, maybe not quite every vowel from Hebrew into English, but it is so close. So close. You need to you take like Abraham. Abraham, or what is in Hebrew known as Abraham, is really a transliteration, all but the B, and the only difference would be in Hebrew, it's called a bait. Without a particular kind of dot in it, becomes a B sound. And the reason why I'm saying that is this. This is what's called power of transliteration. The name of Jesus don't even come near. Doesn't even come near to none of this stuff. But going back here to in Romans 11:1, where it says, "Hath God cast away his people?" Right now, ever who's writing, and we know it was Paul writing the book of Romans here, who he's talking to is Gentiles. When it says God cast away his people, this God is what you're not being told about his name. They have actually come in and stuck in a name that's less than 250 years old, the name of Jesus. What does that, the name of Jesus, have anything to do with the word, with the God of the Old Testament? It does not. You go look up the word God and look up his people, and you're going to find that his people knew who God was and knew who God's name was. And once you do, you're going to find that that name was the name of Yahwah. And it's right here before us as we're reading. It's right there in your Bible. What it is, we've just read this verse and just keep on going. Go find out when Apostle Paul or any of the writers of the New Testament uses the word God. A lot of times it could be the word Elohim. It can be the word El. It's according to how it's used in verses. Some could write it Ha Elohim, meaning the God, or just Elohim, meaning God, or the word El. It's according to how it's used. But regardless, you take the word in your King James Bible, G-O-D, in this verse right here. You go and prove in this verse right here the God that would not cast away his people being Jesus. You'll never find it. You will never find it. When you see that word God, it always refers to, you can find the word Elohim, or but when you just find in something like what you, descriptive titles, I guess. I don't know if that even be what you'd call them. But he has a name. I said he has a name. God's not his name. Elohim's not his name. El's not his name. Lord's not his name. But he does have a name. So when they talk about Elohim, they understand that Elohim, their God, had a name. His name was Yahwah. He was Yahwah Elohim, or Yahwah Elohei, or Yahwah El Shaddai, just ever what. Or El Gibor. And really, just far as just searching this out, I'm trying to get you to understand and get you to understand that when you read these verses are not talking about the name of Jesus. When you see the word God, it's not talking about the name of Jesus. It's talking about the God of the Old Testament, who is Yahwah. And that same God is the one that the Messiah, his own self said, I come in my Father's name. When you read Matthew 28:19, where it says, baptize in the name of the Father, it's talking about Yahwah. Son has to be Yahwah. Holy Spirit has to be Yahwah. Not three gods, three manifestations of one Creator. That flesh of Mashiach took on his Father's name. When you see where it says, catch where his people, works the same way. Who was his people? Israel. Check Israel's gods, the God of Israel out. He has a name. Let me read this again here in Romans 11:1 says, I say then, hath God cast away his people? God forbid. For I also am an Israeli. Of course, they got the King James as Israelite. Some of them can also be translated sometimes. Yisraeli is how they've got it wrote. When you do it that way. As Yisraeli. The way they got it done in English here. That's how they've translated it here in Hebrew here. But again, it says of the seed of Abraham, of the tribe of Benjamin, or Benjamin. Paul is saying, for I am also an Israeli. Paul knew who the Israeli's God was and knew who the Israeli's God was by name. Seed of Abraham, go check Abraham out. Go search Abraham out. Abraham called on the name of Yahwah, built altars unto him. When he was Avram, he built altars unto Yahwah. When he took the full form of the name of Abraham or Avraham, he still built altars unto Yahwah. The tribe of Benjamin knew who the God of Israel was, because they were Israelis, and knew who he was by name. That's what Paul is saying here. Has Yahweh cast away his people? Elohim forbid, or God forbid. For I am an Israeli. That's what Paul is saying. Of the seed of Abraham, of the tribe of Benjamin. And what he's saying, has Yahweh cast away his people? What's the next verse? God hath not cast away his people, which he foreknew. Check the people of Yahweh out from Genesis to Malachi. Those Israelis knew who Yahweh was. Why is not the Gentiles today being taught who Yahweh is? Why are you not being taught the God of Abraham, the God of Israel, the God of Benjamin? Why? The same God. Now I'm using the term as the way the King James does, so you'll understand where I'm coming from. The same God that gave the plan to build altars, to build the tabernacle, to set up the order of the tabernacle, to set up the priesthood. It was all a shadow. But in the shadows, they used the name of Yahwah. Why? Why did the shadows use the name of Yahwah? Because the very image was the name of Yahwah. That's why. That is exactly why. Romans 11:2, here says, God hath not cast away his people, which he foreknew. If you would have lived at the time that these Israelis lived, and you would have called on any other name, if you would have called on Yehoshua other than the name of Yahweh, that would have been totally not accepted. Because even though names such as what you understand in English as Joshua, that goes back to the word Yehoshua, many, 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 like Isaiah, even the name of Isaiah, even the name of Jeremiah, many prophets, many kings had part of the name of the Creator in them. But the only name that was ever given the plan of salvation was the full form, Yud Hey Wav Hey, as Yahwah. That's the only name they called on. They didn't call on Isaiah's. They didn't call on Jeremiah's. They didn't call on Joshua or Yahushua. There wasn't but one name for the name of God, and that was Yahwah, even though a part of his name was in many of these kings, prophets, and different ones. Again, if you've heard the word hallelujah, the word hallelujah is a Hebrew word meaning praise. The word Yah is a word meaning Yah, as it's a short form of Yahwah. It's the first part of Yah, and then the full form is Wah, Yahwah. It was used about 48 times in Scripture, most of them was in Psalms, and you find, I believe it's in the book of about Jah, or as the King James would say, Psalm 68:4, as being Jah. And King James would translate it J-H. It's really the only, for some reason, somehow, it escaped the line pens of these writers from covering up the true name. All you'd have to do is add a Y to the word Jah in Psalm 68:4. With the J, to put a Y, you would have Yah. But what has happened today, it has been, people have been so cheated through all this. The church I'm talking about, not knowing the name of their Creator. Not knowing the name of their Creator. Not knowing the name of their Creator. But people today are not searching out Scripture, are not searching it out. And it's going to take Scripture to understand this. I said it's going to take Scripture to understand this. And you're going to have to go back and study this and examine this out for yourself. I'm trying to encourage you. Here's Apostle Paul in Romans 11:2. God hath not cast away his people, which he foreknew. Wrote ye not what the Scripture saith? And he's talking about of Eliyah. It says here, Elias, but it's really Elijah, or the Hebrew form, Eliyah. Sometimes it's used as Eliyahu. That the Scripture says of Elijah, how he maketh intercession to God against Israel, saying. The third verse says, Lord, the King James says, they have killed thy prophets and dig down thine altar, and I am left alone, and they seek my life. Now, check this out. See what and where Isaiah was, or Elijah was going through different things. I said Elijah going through different things. And why is he going through these different things? You check Elijah out. See who Elijah was calling on. But I'm going to go back here to Romans real quick here in the 11th before we go any farther and go to where it's translated. Here, he talks about Elijah was worried about his life being taken away from him. Now, this is in Romans. Let me read 2 and 3 again in the book of Romans, if I have time. I don't know that I even have time. I do. All right. It says, Romans 11:2, God have not cast away his people, which he have foreknew. Wrought ye not what the Scripture saith? When he's talking about Scripture, he's going back to the Old Testament of Elias, which is talking about Elijah. How he maketh intercession to God against Israel, saying. Now listen to this. Saying. Now here's what it says in verse 3. This is what Paul is writing. Lord. Now he's quoting this from somewhere now. Lord, they have killed thy prophets and dig down thine altars, and I am left alone, and they seek my life. Now, here is Apostle Paul again. In verse 10 of the book of 1 Kings 19:10, this is where Apostle Paul is quoting this. This is Book of Romans 11:3 is quoted from 1 Kings 19:10. He says, "He saith, I have been very jealous for Yahweh God." Look it up and see if it don't use the word Lord. It's in L-O-R-D, capital letters. Check this out and see if it's not talking about the name of Yahweh here. The God of hosts. "For the children of Israel have forsaken thy covenant, thrown down thine altars, and slain thine prophets with the sword. And I am left, and they seek my life to take it away." This is where Apostle Paul is quoting from. 1 Kings 19:10. Romans 11:3 is quoting from 1 Kings 19:10. From Scripture. And he calls them by name. The name of Yahwah. And it looks like our time's come and gone. We're going to pick this back up again next week by His grace and mercy, or whenever you listen to this broadcast. We do appreciate you tuning in. We love you. So till the next broadcast, the same time. Shalom.
The mailing address for Yahwah Ministries is 775 McDonald Road, Covington, Georgia, 30014, USA. 775 McDonald Road, Covington, Georgia, 30014, USA. Phone 770-784-0703. 770-784-0703. Visit the website yahwahministries.org. 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 Until next time, we bid you shalom.